Well, hello again, everybody, and welcome to the Badger Stadium for the Central Viotti Hockey League and hockey at its best. Tonight's feature game, the Badger Bombers versus the Bishop Falls Express. Hi, I'm Ted Patey, along with Jack Stucklish, our color commentary man for tonight's game. And Jack, it should be an exciting one tonight.
Yes, Ted, we're expecting quite a good game tonight between Bishop Falls and Badger. As you know, they've been rivals for quite a long time, and it seems to bring the best out in both teams and in the fans themselves.
Jack, Bishop Falls Express don't seem to be as strong this year as they were last year. I understand they've lost some of their top guns.
Yes, they have. They've lost Tony Bazan, Terry Cook, and, as you know, Gene Faulkner, who was the heart and soul off the Bishop Falls Express.
And, of course, Terry Cook can cause excitement in every game.
And that he can. Terry is a great guy to have back on your blue line. He has speed and size.
And, of course, Tony Bazan can always anchor a good defense.
We all know Tony, and we know what Tony can do.
Hey, Jack, let's talk about the Badger Bombers for a moment, and I understand they got a completely new look this year.
Yes, they have. They have a few players that came up from Grand Falls from the junior ranks, like Talk and Price, Barnes, just to name a few, and we're missing young Manuel, who's out with an injury, and he's supposed to be back.
Of course, Jack, we have some of the old crew from last year when we talk about George Penny and Ewer Hollett and Rodney Howell and Robbie Penny and Peary Paul and those guys, and they can always cause some good excitement, too.
Yeah, they're worth watching. As a matter of fact, Peary just came back now, and he's going to cause some unpleasant moments for Bishop Falls, I would say.
Well, the Bombers are in first place right now. Can you run down the standings for us?
Yes, the Bombers right now have a six-point bulge on Cornerbrook. And then we have Gander, Bishop Falls, Lassie, and Twentygate.
Of course, the excitement this year within the Central Viotti League, of course, is the news that they will be playing for the Herder Memorial Trophy this year.
Yeah, that's a little different from what we've been used to around here, and hopefully that'll draw more fans out, knowing that they are playing for the Herder.
Of course, the opposition we're talking about is the Avalon East League out of St. John's, and that league, I've seen that league, I've watched the players in their play, and it's pretty good, they're pretty competitive. But at the same time, they could be just one or two notches below the caliber of the Central Viotti Hockey League.
Well, I'm sure that Lester Sparks and the Badger Bombers will be happy to hear that.
Well, certainly we're looking forward to it, and if the Badger Bombers should happen, or the Bishop Falls Express should happen to represent the Central Viotti League, I'm sure we'll be covering that for the fans out there, and it should be exciting.
Yeah, I agree with you, Ted.
Okay, Jack, let's listen to the national anthem now, and then we'll go to center ice for the opening faceoff. Well, it's game time here at the Badger Stadium in the Central Viotti Hockey League, where we'll see tonight the Badger Bombers playing the Bishop Falls Express, Jack, and I think we're in for a good one. We have quite a few fans on hand tonight, and of course, the starting lineups now for Badger. We will have Craig Hayden, yes, and George Penny on defense up front. We'll have Yubi Holland, Craig Loader, and Wayne Little. And for Bishop Falls, we'll have Tony Kennedy and Ken Feller on defense with Rob Fudge, Greg Byrne, and Darren Drover at center ice. From the faceoff, the puck is shot into the Bishop Falls zone. Yubi Holland in fighting for possession in front of the net. Gets it to the side of the net. He's pushed out of the play. And already she's starting to get rough down there in the Bishop Falls Express zone. And the referee blows it down, and we'll have a face-off out to the left of Barry Sugaroo.
Yeah, I see Badger made a quick change on defense. He had now Peary Paul and Robbie Penny on defense.
That's correct, Jack. And from the face-off, it's behind the Bishop Falls net. Fired up to the blue line. Tony Kennedy taken out of the play by Craig Loader. Peary Paul ridden into the boards by number six, by Rob Fudge. There's a shot, and that's wide. And we have another whistle.
The net is off the moorings at the other end, at the Bishop Falls end of the rink. I'm wondering why Badger made a quick change on defense there, taking George Penny's defensive pair off and putting on Robbie Penny and Peary Paul.
Well, a move, I'm sure, that Coach Crocher to coincide with the Bishop Falls line that was out there, Jack. We'll have a face-off now just outside the Bishop Falls blue line. From the face-off, Darren Drover slides it back in the Bishop Falls zone where it comes back to center ice. And Perry Paul fires it right back in. Number 18, Wayne Little, trying to set up the front of the net. There's a shot, and that's just wide. Buck is shot out to center ice. Roger Kennedy fires it off to the blue line where Keith Loader picks it up. Craig Hayden at center ice. Fanned on his pass at the blue line, fires a shot. Sugaroo stirs that aside. Number 5, Len Penny fires it off the boards. And Robbie Penny fires it right back in. Number 79, Craig Ellis, fighting for possession of the puck, and they'll freeze it on the boards, and we'll have another face-off with 18:47 left in the first period. No score, Badger Bombers and the Bishop Falls Express.
We should mention that the referee and linesman are all from Gander tonight for tonight's game.
Mm-hmm. From the face-off, puck is back to center ice. And there's Russ Kennedy, makes a nice move, gets around one defenseman, but then he's stopped by Len Penny and is fired up to center ice. There's a shot, Roger Kennedy steers that aside. Number 9, Junior Butt, fired a pass at the center ice, and that was almost intercepted by number 44 of the Bishop Falls Express. And the puck is now fired to center ice. Number 2 for Badger, fires it up to Junior Butt. Junior Butt into Russ Kennedy, back to Butt. It's over to George Penny, there's a shot. That was deflected into the corner. And number 2 for Badger, fights for possession of the puck. Greg Hayden fires it back to center ice. Bobby Penny in the Junior Butt. Junior Butt pushed out of the play, and we'll have another face-off with 17:49 left. Pace is a little slow here at the beginning of the first period, Jack, but I'm sure it's going to pick up as we progress along the way.
Yeah, there's no doubt it's going to liven up a bit before the night is over.
Number 12, Wayne Sullivan loses the draw, shot in the corner with Tony Kennedy. Behind his own net, watched by number 3. Pete Evans fires it right back in, and now it's picked up by number 3, Steve Burns. Up to number 12, Wayne Sullivan. The puck is in the Bishop Falls zone. Tony Kennedy fires it off the boards. It's still at the blue line. Now it's out to center ice. There's a race for the puck. And Rodney Howell takes the Bishop Falls Express player, Terry Golding, heavy into the boards. And we'll have another face-off to the right of Roger Kennedy. Rodney Howell making a good play, taking Terry Golding into the boards. Calls the face off just to the right of Roger Kennedy. On the draw, there's a shot by Greg Byrne. That was just wide. There's another shot over the top of the net. Number 5, Len Penny keeps it in behind the net for number 7. Pete Evans taking out a play, and Wayne Sullivan can't get it out. And number 3, Steve Burns is at the Bishop Falls blue line. He's stopped by number 5, Len Penny. And Penny takes it and fires it over the blue line. Here comes the Bishop Falls Express. There's a shot. And a pad saved by Roger Kennedy. Sullivan up to number 3, Steve Burns. He's over the Bishop Falls blue line. And the puck is shot right back in the Badger zone. Perry Paul off the boards to Pete Evans. There's a weak shot. And Perry Paul, with the puck behind his own net, moves it out, fires a heading pass to Hubert Holland. He stopped at center ice, and Greg Byrne, taken out of the play by number 5, Perry Paul. They both go to the ice. And we'll have a face-off with 16-12 remaining in the first period.
That was a good check there, Ted, that Perry Paul threw on Greggy Byrne, but I think that there's a penalty being called to Hubert Holt on Badger, captain of the Badger team. 16-12 left in the first period, no score.
And now the Bishop Falls Express will go on the power play. They'll have their top guns out there, Tony Kennedy and Ken Fowler on defense, with Darren Drover, Rob Fudge, and Greggy Byrne. Tony Kennedy moves out of his own end. Up to number 44, Mike Bennett, and he's intercepted by number 20, Craig Lord, and we'll have another face-off.
You'll be all it was called for slashing at 3:48 at first period.
3:48 for slashing. Now Greg Byrne at his own blue line, fires it off to Mike Bennett. He's in over blue line. There's a shot, and that was just wide. Tony Kennedy winds up, fires it into the corner. Darren Drover tries to get it out to Greg Byrne, and number 18 for the Badger Bombers just fires it down to the Bishop Falls zone. Now number 44, Mike Bennett, watched by Wayne Little. Mike Bennett, back to Greg Byrne behind the net. Bennett up to his own blue line, fires it up to center ice. And the Express are over the blue line. There's a shot and a big pad save by Roger Kennedy off Darren Drover, number 15. Pucks right back in the Bishop Falls end. Greg Byrne up to his own blue line, taken out of the play by number 44, Keith Loader. Number 10, Russ Kennedy. Fires it deep in the Bishop Falls zone. Barry Sugaroo out behind his own net. And it's picked up by number 44, Keith Loader. Loader up to Russ Kennedy. Back to Loader. Russ Kennedy back to center ice. Up to Keith Loader at the Bishop Falls blue line. Makes a nice move. There's a shot, and that was wide. Pucks out in front. Mike Bennett up to center ice. Fires it in the Badger end, where George Penny takes it and fires it right back to center ice. The Express at the Bishop Falls blue line. George Penny behind his own net, watched by number 12, Bill Faulkner, and the puck is shot out to center ice. There's number 9, Junior Butt moves in, and he's taken out of the play by Dan Sullivan. 14, Penny lets go a hard shot. And that was about 2 feet wide. Pucks over to number 31 and Corey Pretty. Fires it out to center ice. Back at the Badger blue line. Russ Kennedy. Pucks back at center ice. George Penny fires it in to number 3, Steve Burns. He's intercepted there and the puck is shot in the Badger end. And now we'll have a blown down Jack on the face-off at 13:29 left and still no score.
The Badger successfully killed off that penalty without too much trouble, except for one good shot there by Darren Drover, which Kennedy was up to. Bishop Falls seemed to have the better of the play through the first 6.5 minutes of this hockey game.
Terry Golding, Jerry Penny, and Corey Pretty up front for Bishop Falls. Bobby Bogdan makes his way to his own blue line, up the center ice, over to Bishop Falls blue line. He couldn't get around Tony Kennedy. Now the puck is back to number 4, Rodney Howell. He shoots it right back in. Earth picked up behind the net by number 11, Tony Kennedy. Kennedy up to number 31, Corey Pretty up the center ice. And number 34, Jerry Penny almost got free. But he's taken out of the play by Rodney Howell. And the whistle is blown down. And we have another penalty, Jack.
Yes, we have another penalty being called here, Ted. It's a hooking call. Number four, Rodney Howell, is getting the gate. We weren't sure exactly who was going to get the gate here. It was Rodney Howell for hooking.
And Bishop Falls Express will go on the power play. Darren Drover, Greg Burr, Rob Fudge.
Number four, Howell. 10 minutes for hook.
Tony Kennedy behind his own net up to Darren Drover. Drover's at center ice. He's over the Badger blue line. And he misses a check by Paul. There's a shot and a big save by Kennedy. And number 10, Russ Kennedy, shoots it all the way down the Bishop Falls end. Tony Kennedy lays it for number 15, Darren Drover, behind his own net. He's watched there by Keith Loader. Drover over to Greg Byrne. Back to Byrne. Byrne all to his own blue line, up to center ice. Fires it in the corner behind the Badger nut, and Perry Paul failed to get it out near the puck in front. Shot across, Roger Kennedy flexed that one out front, and Keith Loader fires it all the way down the ice. Where the Bishop Falls Express will regroup. Now intercepted by Russ Kennedy. And the Express is on the way back at the blue line. You're over to Badger line. There's a shot by Greg Byrne and another save by Roger Kennedy. Tony Kennedy winds up. And that's blocked by Keith Loader, who falls in front and deflects that puck right deep in the Bishop Falls end. Number six, Rob Fudge behind his own net. Fires it off to Tony Kennedy up to center ice. There was stopped by number 79, Craig Ellis, and we have another whistle with 11:23 left in the first period. Jack, I'd like to make mention here tonight, the fans, we have the American Hockey League official and a former senior referee from St. John's and tonight's attendance, of course, in the first of Donnie Welch. And we have the recreation director from Bishop Falls, Ron Healy, no stranger to sports fans, but across the province. Pucks behind the Badger net. George Penny, taken out of the play by number 79, Craig Ellis. And it's back to the blue line where Len Penny failed to keep it in. And we have an offside. And Jack, the faceoff will go outside the Badger blue line.
Yes, the faceoff will probably be called all the way back, Ted, on this one because it was deliberate offside. Badger has been killing off now two penalties in the first 9 minutes of this hockey game. And thanks, I think, to a lot to Roger Kennedy, that the score remains at 0-0 with 11 minutes left in the first period.
He'll line up for the face-off. From the draw, back to Keith, to George Penny. He fires it wide of the net. Wayne Little tries to get it out, and that's stopped by number 79, Craig Ellis. Ellis fires the puck out to center ice, and that's stopped by Stretch Hayden. Hayden fires it right back in, and number two, Dan Sutherland fires it in the Badger end. And we have another penalty coming up on the play. George Penny fights for possession at the puck and is blown down, Jack. And we have another penalty on the play.
Yes, we have a penalty this time called against Bishop Falls on that play. So now Badger will get a chance to try their power play. They successfully, after killing two of their own, and now they will go on the power play.
This game has been brought to you by Cable 9, Channel 9, Cable Atlantic, Grand Falls. 10:32 left in the first period, no score. And Jack, when we mention Ron Healy from Bishop Falls, is no stranger to sports fans across the province. Ron having refereed in the senior NAHA for years and did a pretty good job.
Yes, Ron was always a pretty colorful referee every game that I've seen him do. I'd like to mention too, Ted, that we probably got the biggest crowd of the season on hand tonight.
A fair fan attendance, Jack, from the faceoff. George Penny at his own blue line at center ice. He's across the Bishop Falls blue line, taken out of the play by number six, Rob Fudge. Now there's Yubi Hollick trying to get in front. And a shot by number 20, and that was just wide. Number 20, Craig Hayden, just fired that one wide. And we'll have another face-off deep in the Bishop Falls zone, just to the left of Barry Sugaroo. And Jack, I might add here, Donnie Walsh, former senior referee in the NAHA, and now an official scorer with the American Hockey League, St. John's Maple Leafs from St. John's. And of course, Donnie Walsh, no stranger either to sports fans right across the province. From the face-off, Puck is shot in the Badger end. Eisen is waved off. Of course, Bishop Falls are short-handed, killing off the penalty now with the Bombers on the power play. They'll regroup in their own end. Wayne Little fires it off to Craig Loader. He's stopped there by number six, Rob Fudge, and the puck is right back in the Badger own. George Penny, and another penalty coming up to Bishop Falls, a delayed penalty. Craig Loader at the blue line fires it in, and another penalty to the Bishop Falls Express.
Yeah, I think you'll get a penalty here to Greggy Byrne, number eight of Bishop Falls, who took a punch at Craig Loader in retaliation penalty. These are usually the ones that are called.
9:39 left in the first period. There's no score between the Badger Bombers and the Bishop Falls Express. And Jack, one player that's absent out there tonight for the Bishop Falls Express, and you can really notice the absence of course Wayne Faulkner. Wayne on the injury list and behind the bench tonight.
Yes, Wayne always draws a crowd, especially he'll draw Perry Paul around him every time he gets on the ice. Him and Perry over the years have quite a rivalry going.
From the face-off, pucks it behind the net, flying to the blue line, Perry Paul stops it, fires it over to number 66, Robbie Penny, who fired a pass to Sullivan, and now it's back to the blue line. Robbie Penny, over to Perry Paul, he winds up with a shot, and a big save by Barry Sugaroo, and he'll hold on, Jack.
Yes, Perry was allowed, they allowed him to walk in, everybody got out of the way, and let Sugaroo see the shot, and he had no problem with it.
Of course, Perry Paul was probably one of the hardest shots in the league, and he really let that one go, but Sugaroo come up big.
Badger are enjoying a two-man advantage at the moment.
On the face-off, the Bombers still on the power play. Over to Penny, back to Robbie Penny, a shot, and that was just wide. And number 44, Mike Bennett, fires it off the boards for Roger Penny, leaves it for Robbie Penny. Up to number five, Perry Paul into Ross Kennedy, and we have an offside with exactly 9 minutes left in the first period. Jack, as we look down below us here, Roger Kennedy in the net for the Badger Bombers just last week in St. John's. Of course, Roger was backup goaltender to the Robert Horino off the St. John's Maple Leafs, and we almost had a chance to see Roger in goal that night when Horino took an injury, but he was all right, got back in the net, and we never did get to see Roger. He could have probably played the following weekend in Cape Breton, but he had commitments to the Badger Bombers, and this is where he came. Of course, they won two big games last weekend. There's a shot from close in from Russ Kennedy, and Barry Sugaroo once again comes up, Jack, that time with a big glove save.
Yes, Barry Sugaroo wasn't tested early, but he's certainly getting tested on this power play. And getting back to Roger Kennedy, Ted, Roger, during the past two seasons that he played in Badger, I don't know if he's missed a hockey game.
That's right, Jack, and a steady, consistent goaltender. Now there's the puck over to Perry Paul. He winds up with a shot. And another save by Sugaroo. Bobby Penley picked up the extra 2 minutes for checking from behind. And now the teams will play four aside. And now there's a pass intercepted by the Bishop Falls Express at the blue line. And it's shot in. Roger Kennedy behind his own net gives it up to Darren Drover. And Bobby Bugden, watched by Drover. He's hooked from behind and hauled down, no penalty on the play. And Rodney Howell fights for the assist in the puck with Greg Snow. And that's whistled down, and we'll have another face-off. To the right of Roger Kennedy with 7:52 left in the first period. From the face-off, there's a weak shot from the blue line, and Roger Kennedy fires it up to brother Russ Kennedy, over to number 18. Number 18 for Badgers in the corner, Wayne Little, and now the puck is back to center ice. Back in the Badger end, and it's picked up by Russ Kennedy. Kennedy makes a nice move to get around Greg Byrne, but he's intercepted there by Drover. Kennedy once again, dipsy-dooling around inside of his own blue line over to Bobby Bugden. who fires it all the way deep into the Bishop Hall zone. Number 11, Tony Kennedy, behind his own net. He's watched by Wayne Little. Kennedy still with the puck, fires it off to Ken Fowler. Up to center ice, and the express over the blue line, and Kennedy moves out and fires the puck off the glass. When number 6, Robbie Fudge, had a chance to get in all alone, but Kennedy skated out and fired the puck off the glass. Now Greg Byrne makes his way to center ice. Inside the Badger blue line. Fires it out to number 2, Dan Sutherland, and he missed the pass. Now UB Holler. Fires it up to Craig Loader. And that's taken by number 44, Mike Bennett. UB Holler takes possession. Back to number 2 to stretch Hayden. There's a shot. And that's just wide of the net. And the puck is back, shot back in the Badger end. We'll have an icing call, Jack, with 6:07 left in the period. No score between the Badger Bombers and the Bishop Falls Express on Channel 9 Central Cable.
Greg Hayden took that shot to Tate from the blue line. It was deflected and just missed the open side. One of the better, most improved players in this league is Greg Hayden.
Well, this is the first time I saw Greg Hayden, Jack, and he's playing pretty consistent there on the blue line. As they line up to the right of Barry Sugaroo. From the faceoff, Russ Kennedy, back to Robbie Penny. And there's a shot by number 9, Junior Butt. And number 31, Corey Pretty, taken out of the play by Keith Loader. The puck flies right across the crease. And it's blown down, Jack. I think the net is off its moorings once again. And we have a penalty, the number 5, Len Penny of the Bishop Isles Express.
Yes, I think he's going for interference, Ted, according to the ref single there. Badger were putting on pretty good pressure at that time. Both goaltenders are playing pretty well in the first period. 5:52 left in the period. No score in a hockey game.
Now while we wait the face-off, the Lions will make the adjustment on the net in the Bishop Falls end with 5:52 left in the period and no score in the game.
14:08.
They'll line up for the face-off. Russ Kennedy will take the draw for Badger. And number 20, Terry Gordon for Bishop Falls. There's a shot just wide. Terry Paul keeps it in at his own blue line. Up to Junior Bud. That shot just shot across the crease. There's a shot. He scores! Russ Kennedy. Let a hard shot go. That got by Barry Sugaroo, Jack, and I think he was screened on the play.
Yes, it was quite a hard shot that Russ Kennedy had there. Beautiful setup from Junior Butt, and Perry Paul kept the puck in at the point which started the play. So it should be Kennedy from Butt and Perry Paul.
And that goal coming with 5:39 left in the first period. And the Badger Bombers take the lead, 1-0 over the Bishop Falls Express. They line up at center ice now for the faceoff. UB Holler wins the draw, back to Rodney Howell. Howell up to number 18, Wayne Sullivan. He fires it deep in the express zone. And now number 79, Craig Ellis, up to center ice. Stopped there by Wayne Little.
Bad goal, scored by number 10, Kennedy. Assisted by number 9, number 5, Howell. Bad goal, 14:08.
14:08, the time of the goal. Russ Kennedy from Perry Paul. And there's another shot. And now we have fisticuffs down in the corner. Number 20, Craig Kennedy. We don't know who the Bishop Falls player is as of right now. And the Lions went in there fairly quick, Jack, to break this one up.
Yes, that's number 20, Craig Loader there, Ted, from Badger. And I can't see the number from Bishop Falls as yet.
All the officials got in there pretty quick and broke
that
one up.
Looks like 31, I think, Corey Pretty, I believe.
You're right, Jack. Number 31, Corey Pretty. And number 20, Craig Kennedy off the Bombers. And I don't know if that will be five minute fighting majors or not. We'll wait the official call.
I would assume that it's probably roughing because there's no punches thrown. It was just a wrestling match, really.
Well, it looks like, Jack, it could be 5 minute fighting majors. Craig Loader heading for the dressing room, and it's 5:04 left in the game, as well as number 31, Corey Pretty.
Yes, I think that referee Brown is going to call this pretty close tonight between those two teams. He doesn't want to let it get out of hand, I guess, early, but I don't think it warranted 5 minutes, probably two. It was only a wrestling match.
.504 left in the period. 1-0 for the Badger Bombers. And Jack, looking behind the players in the Badger bench, we see another no stranger to hockey fans in Newfoundland, Steve Croucher, who played with the Grand Falls Cataracts and was one of the top imports that was brought into the province. Out from the face-off, the puck is back in the Badger zone. Wayne Little over to Bobby Bugden. Bugden up the center ice. That's intercepted by number 44, Mike Benner. Benner at center ice. Up to Bugden. Number 34, Jerry Penny, fires it right back in. Bugden, number 15, makes a nice move to get around 44. Mike Bennett's up to UB Hollett. Hollett taken out of the play by number 5, Len Penny. And the puck's behind the net at the number 9. There's a shot by Bugden. And that was just wide. Jerry Penny stopped at his own blue line. And now Mike Benner. Over the Badger blue line, watched by UB Hollett. Out in front, there's a shot, he scores! Number 34, Jerry Penny. From number 19, Greg Stowe. And I think Mike Benner. And Jack, that ties this game at one apiece.
Yeah, it was a nice goal, nice passing play there, and finished off by number 34, Jerry Penny.
Penny from number 31, Corey Pretty, and from, I think it was Greg Snow, number 19. Now, Mike Benn and Greg Snow, we await the official call. 4:09 left in the period. Game's tied, 1-1. Number 12, Sullivan. Over to Pete Evans. Puck is at center ice for Darren Drover. Fires it back to Tony Kennedy. Kennedy over to Fowler. Pucks at center ice. There's the Bishop Falls Express behind the net. Darren Drover taken out of the play of Pete Evans. Pass it over to Wayne Sullivan. Sullivan watched by number 8, Greg Burns. And number 2, Stretch Hayden, taken heavily on the boards by number 6.
Delayed penalty being called.
A delayed penalty call coming up here, and we had 3:19 in the period. Jack, I think, the Bishop Falls Express.
Yes, penalty to Bishop Falls. Number 6, Rob Fudge. It could be either charging or elbowing, I believe.
.319 left in the first period. The Badger Bomber won and the Bishop Falls Express won. And this is hockey at its best in the Central Beatty Hockey League here at Channel 9, Cable Atlantic. Kennedy skates back to his net to wait the face-off. Russ Kennedy loses the draw. Tony Kennedy farms it all the way down the Badger end. Kennedy. Roger Kennedy leaves it for number 66, Robbie Penny, to Russ Kennedy, back to Penny, up to number 4, Keith Loader, he's over the blue line, takes number 16, heavy out of the play, and the puck is back into Russ Kennedy. Russ Kennedy in the corner, fires it out front, puck is intercepted, and Darren Drover fires it to Leonard the Ice, and Kennedy blocks that one, leaves it for Perry Paul. A nice move by Paul to get around Greg Byrne. He's at the Bishop Falls blue line. He's all alone. He reaches in, he lets the shot go. And a big save by Barry Sugaroo. Back out to Robbie Penny. And that's another shot high. In the corner, number 9, Junior Bott takes his man out of the play. Back to Robbie Penny. Over to Perry Paul. Paul shoots it out front. There's a shot. And Russ Kennedy just failed to put that one in. Robbie Penny back into Russ Kennedy. Makes it out in front. Let the shot go. And another save by Sugaroo. And the puck is shot down the Badger area. Kennedy comes all the way to the blue line. Shoots it off to Robbie Penny. Over to Perry Paul. He's over to Bishop Hall. Blue line. There's a hard shot. And a big pad save by Sugaroo. And the puck shot back the Badger end. Kennedy out of his net. Leads it for Robbie Penny. Over to the Brother George, number 14, up to Yubi Holland. He's over to Bishop Hall, blue line, back to Sullivan. There's a shot. Wayne Little failed to deflect that one. And Roger Kennedy passes it up to number 14, Penny, over to Pete Evans. Well, that's Steve Burns. He stopped at center ice. And number 18, Wayne Little, over to Bishop Hall, blue line, shoots it in the corner. Chasing Dan Sutherland behind the Bishop Falls net. And the puck is back out to center ice. There's Jerry Penny coming in again. A shot, he scores! Number 6, Rob Fudge. On a weak shot that got by Roger Kennedy. And the Bishop Falls Express go up by 1 goal. As they now lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 2-1. Jack, that goal coming at 1:05 left in the first period.
Yes, Roger looked a little off guard on that one coming in from the left side. Well, it was a good shot.
Bishop Hall goal for number 6, Fudge, unassisted. Top goal, 1855.
1855, Robbie Fudge, unassisted. And the face-off from center ice, Penny. Intercepted by number 12, Bill Faulkner. And the Bishop Falls Express gets over the blue line again. With Robbie Fudge almost getting in all alone. Now Fudge. Taken out of the play by George Penny. And Steve Burns at his own blue line. Taken out of the play by number 6, Rob Fudge. And number 2, Stretch Hayden. Fires it deep into Bishop Falls end. Barry Sugaroo leaves it, shoots it up to the center line. Bill Faulkner lets his shot go. Kennedy kicks that aside. Puck shot in behind the Badger net. Bobby Bogdan watched by Bill Faulkner in front. Puck is up the center ice. Steve Burns at the Bishop Falls blue line. And that's stopped there by the Express and shot back to the Badger blue line. And there's the first period, Jack. And the Bishop Falls Express lead this one by a score of 2-1, Jack. And if you want to give us a rundown of that first period.
Yes, Badger took the lead, did.
The Bombers, yes, Jack, took the lead there early in the first period.
Yes, but Russ Kennedy getting the goal to put them ahead. And then Jerry Penny tied the game, and Robbie Fudge put them ahead with less than a minute left in the first period.
So after the first period, the Bishop Falls Express lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 2-1. What's that?
In Nepal, children care for children while their parents must work to grow food. USC Canada works with Nepali partners building daycare centers and schools. Here, children develop skills to begin building better lives for themselves and their families. USC Canada, building tomorrow, today. I'm Bruce Coburn for USC Canada, 56 Spark Street, Ottawa.
Well, we're back to the second period between the Badger Bombers and the Bishop Falls Express. The Bishop Falls Express lead the Bombers by a score of 2-1. I'm Ted Patey, along with Jack Stuckfish, with your color commentary. Out of pocket, back to the Badger blue line. Back up to center ice for Tony Kennedy. Puck taken by UB Hollett. Back to Hollett, but the pass failed to materialize. And Darren Drover. Points for possession on the puck for Wayne Little. And a shot to the other side. Robbie Penny. Bobby Penny keeps the puck in and at the same time takes Greg Boone out of the play. Boone behind his own net over to number 15, Darren Drover. Back to Tony Kennedy. Kennedy up to center ice over the Badger blue line and he's stopped there by George Penny. Now number 9, Junior Butt. Up to the Bishop Falls blue line. And the puck shot off the boards and into the crowd, and we'll have a face-off with 18:39 left in the second period.
That was quite a check there that George Penny put in on Greg Byrne.
Well, Byrne was taken out of the play, and at the same time, Penny just took the puck and moved on. We'll have a face-off now to the right of the Gander, the Bishop Falls goaltender, Barry Sugaroo. Ross Kennedy lines up for the faceoff against number 19, Greg Snow. From the faceoff, Kennedy wins. There's a shot from Perry Pons in front. And Junior Butt, number 9, was all alone in front of Barry Sugaroo, and he failed to put it in.
Great save by Sugaroo off of Junior Butt there. It was a great shot from Perry Pons that set it up in the point. And Junior Butt was left all alone in front of Sugaroo. He came up big.
Sugaroo playing a strong game tonight for the Bishop Falls Express. On defense for the Bishop Falls Express, Len Penny, there's a shot and a skate save by Sugaroo. Now Robbie Penny fires it back in behind the Bishop Falls net over to Ross Kennedy. He's stopped by number 34, Jerry Penny. Perry Paul at his own blue line fires it over to Robbie Penny. Back up to center ice. Perry Paul fires it in for Ross Kennedy. Kennedy in the line of the boards with number 2, Dan Sullivan, and they'll freeze the puck for another faceoff. 18-03. This is hockey at its best in the Central Bialtic Hockey League, where the Badger Bombers play the Bishop Falls Express, and the Express lead this game by a score of 2-1.
Perry Paul is certainly playing a strong game for Badger, both offensively and defensively tonight.
Face-off to the right of Roger Kennedy. Mike Bennett will take the face-off for the Bishop Falls Express as he lines up against number 6, Jerry Power. Puck is shot down the Badger end. Roger Kennedy fires it up to his own blue line where Bobby Bogdan skates over to the boards. He's up at center ice. He's taken down from behind. And a delayed penalty on the call. And number 34, Jerry Penny, or get the gate jack for tripping with 17:45 left in the second period.
Yes, Bobby Bugden was really winding up that time in full steam when he got hooked from behind by Penny.
Now the Badger Bombers will go on the power play with UB Hollett lining up for the faceoff along with Russ Kennedy and Keith Loader. For Bishop Falls, Tony Kennedy, Greg Byrne, Rob Pretty, and Paul Lingard. Now Tony Kennedy at his own blue line, fires it down deep in the Badger end. Roger Kennedy behind his own net. He's watched by Greg Byrne, almost lost it. Alapuck, Keith Lauder up to Ross Kennedy to UB Hollett. He's over to Bishop Ball blue line in the Ross Kennedy. Lauder watched by Lingard. Lewis at the puck to Tony Kennedy. He's watched by Russ Kennedy and fired back to center ice. Rodney Howell over to Bobby Bogdan. Russ Kennedy stopped at the Bishop Falls blue line by Tony Kennedy. Bogdan fires it in around the glass. And Paul Lingard fires the puck to Len on the ice. And Roger Kennedy had to come up with the save. Play sloppy right now, Jack, with 16:43 left in the second period, and with the Bombers on the power play, the Bishop Falls Express seemed to control the play.
Yes, that was a very poor power play that the Bombers had out that time, Ted. Bishop Falls knew how to play it. They shot the puck in, and Bishop Falls just shot it back out again.
They'll line up for the faceoff to the left of Roger Kennedy. Ross Kennedy will take the faceoff for the Badger Bomber. On the faceoff, there's a shot by Sutherland, stopped by Kennedy. George Penny in the corner, fires it up to the blue line. Oh, and Wayne Little taken out of the play, heavy by number two, Dan Sutherland. Number 16, Ken Fowler, fires it back in the Badger end, and George Penny up the center ice to Ross Kennedy. He's over the Bishop Falls blue line, trying to make the extra move to get around number 16, Ken Fowler, but couldn't. Kenny Fowler playing a steady game on defense tonight for the Express. Puck is shot out to the Badger blue line, picked up by George Penny. He's at center ice. That's a slap shot goal. That's blocked by Sugaroo and Sutherland. Couldn't get it out. Penny. That's another shot going. That's deflected by Sugaroo. We have a delayed penalty coming up to Bishop Falls. And that's blowing down, and the Badger Bombers again will go on the power play, Jack.
Yes, I didn't quite catch that, who got that penalty, Ted. I was watching the play on the other side of the rink there. But in the last few seconds of that power play, they certainly came to life again.
15:35 left in the second period. You're watching Hockey at its Best on Channel 9, Central Cable Atlantic. The referee for tonight's game, Blair Brown from Gander. And doing a good job, Jack, I might add.
Yes,
Johnny Walsh, the referee, one of the senior referees, tell me that Blair has come up good as one of the top referees in the central area.
Yes, it's one of the better refereed games that I've seen all year, and I've seen most of all of the Badger games at home and some on the road.
From the faceoff, Greg Byrne lines up against Keith Loader. From the draw, Len Penny fires it out to the blue line, couldn't get it out, it's back behind the Bishop Hall net, and you'll be hollering. Fail to pick it up, Tony Kennedy fires it out of his own end, and Roger Kennedy fires it right back. Len Penny fires a shot. That hits referee Blair Brown, now number eight, Greg Byrne. He stopped at his own blue line by Keith Loader. And number six, Robbie Fudge. Fires it deep in the Badger end. Perry Paul. Watched by Rob Fudge. It's up to Yubi Hollett. Oh, he makes a nice play. He was tripped up by Len Penny. And number eight, Greg Byrne, lets a shot go from center ice. That's blocked by Kennedy. Hollett at the Bishop Falls blue line. And he's taken out of the play there by number five, Len Penny. Roger Kennedy. Goaltender with the Badger Bombers tried to fire to his own blue line but was intercepted by Greg Byrne. And now Robbie Penny. Penny fires it up to Perry Paul. He's over Bishop Falls blue line. There's a shot. And Sugaroo makes a big stick save on that hard slap shot by Perry Paul from about 15 feet out. Perry Paul behind the Bishop Falls net. Watched by Mike Bennett. Out to the blue line, Keith Loader. And then you'll be hollering. There's the puck in front of the net, and Sugaroo comes up with a great glove save with 14:04 left in the second period.
Yes, Perry Paul, as I mentioned before, is really coming up big for Badger tonight. One of the better games that I've seen him play all year. Certainly he hasn't played many because he's only just gotten back in the lineup a while ago.
They'll line up for the face-off to the left of Barry Sugaroo. Mike Bennett will take the draw against Russ Kennedy.
Seemed to have
Dan
a problem
Sutherland.
With the door.
A little problem with the door, that's right. Jack Dan Sutherland and number four, Paul Lingard, back on defense for the Express. 14:04 left in the second period. The Express lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 2-1. Well, plays back into action from the faceoff. Lingard was it to his own blue line, couldn't get it out. And Russ Kennedy. Now at center ice, the puck is fired deep and the Bishop falls in the Badger end. Rodney Harrell at his own blue line, the center ice. Fires it in the corner. And number two, Sullivan, fires it off the boards and down the ice. Both teams are even, five aside. Now Russ Kennedy. Stop that center ice, and Bobby Bogdan behind his own net, watched by number 79, Craig Ellis. Puck is over to Bishop Falls blue line, back at center ice, and Howell fires it in the corner. And we have number 16, Harry Foley, taking his first shift of the game tonight for the Badger Bombers. There's a shot by Ellis, kicked out by Kennedy. Over number two, Sutherland lets a shot go, he scores! Dan Sutherland from the slot. And a shot go that beat Kennedy to the stick side. Jack and the Express have now gone ahead by a score of 3-1.
Yes, the Express are playing very well tonight, Ted. That was a shot that went right between the legs of Kennedy. But well, it was well set up.
That goal coming with 12:49 left in the second period. And the Bishop Falls Express now lead by a score of 3-1. And Jack, the Bishop Falls Express, with the loss of Terry Cook and Tony Bazan and Geno Faulkner and Wayne Faulkner not playing tonight, I'm surprised. You know, they are playing a strong game considering the loss of those players. Tony Kennedy, who always plays a consistent game on defense, in front of his own net, watched by Pete Evans, number 7, Kennedy, fires it up the center ice, the pass fails to make contact with Jerry Golding and Will Faulkner, offside at the Badger blue line. 12:21 left in the second period, the Express lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 3-1. As they line up for the face-off outside the blue line, the Badger blue line. Puck is at center ice. Len Penny fires it in off the boards. Where is picked up behind the Badger net by George Penny. Penny watched by number 12, Bill Faulkner. Makes Penny circle around his own net once again. And now Jerry Golding loses it to Stretch Hayden. Up to Hubert Hollett, now Wayne Litter at center ice. He's over to Bishop Falls blue line into Pete Evans, and he fans on the shot. And Len Penny fires it back out to center ice. Now here's Wayne Litter. And the play is whistled down, and we'll have another face-off just outside the Bishop Falls blue line.
We have 11:41 left in the second period. The score is Bishop Falls 3, Badger 1. And Bishop Falls are full marks for the two-goal advantage that they have at the moment.
Ross Kennedy will take the face-off against number 6, Rob Fudge. Kennedy wins the draw over to Perry Paul. He lets a shot go. That's a couple of feet wide. Junior Butt loses the puck. Back to the blue line. Robbie Penny lets a shot go. And a beautiful pad saved by Sugaroo. Number 6, Rob Fudge over the Badger blue line, taken heavy out of the play by Robbie Penny. And the puck now behind the Badger net. Number 15, Darren Drover, fight for possession of the puck with Keith Loader. And the puck is shot out to center ice. Number 16, Kenny Fowler, shoots it back in. And it comes right back in to number 2. Dan Sutherland and Roger Kennedy. Out of his net, he'll hold on for the face-off with 10:51 left in the second period.
Badger are playing very sloppy tonight. They're not under game, and maybe it's because Bishop Falls are playing so well.
Bishop Falls really playing a strong game tonight. Like you say, Tony Kennedy always playing a consistent game on defense. Len Penny a standout tonight, as well as down Dan Sutherland. All strong on defense, and they lead this game by a score of 3-1. Now number 16, Fowler, fires the puck in the corner. Number 2, Sutherland, takes a shot, that's to the side of the net, and it's blown down for another faceoff. Just like to make mention here, Jack, as we mentioned before, one of the fans in attendance tonight is the American Hockey League official and scorekeeper with the St. John's Maple Leafs and a former senior referee in the Newfoundland Senior Hockey League. And of course, that's Donnie Walsh. Donnie, we were just informed that Donnie has put up 2 tickets for a hockey game in St. John's, of course, with the St. John's Maple Leafs, and that will be drawn. I think Jack has a door prize about 3 weeks down the road, so we'll have 2 lucky people from Badger probably enjoying the St. John's Maple Leafs right at St. John's Memorial Stadium. Our thanks goes out once again to Donnie Welch, no stranger to sports fans right across the province. From the faceoff, the puck is shot over the Bishop Fowler blue line, Sutherland. That's intercepted by Bobby Buck, and there's a shot! And a big save by Sugaroo, and Pete Evans failed to put it in. Drover taken out of the play by Rodney Howell. And number 8, Greg Byrne, circles behind the Badger net, and Sutherland makes a big play in there in the Badger end. Now number 4, Howell, shoots it behind his own net where Bobby Bugden falls and shoots the puck, and it goes to the crowd, and we'll have another faceoff.
They're getting back those 2 tickets to the AHL game in St. John's. Not necessary that someone from Badger is going to win this, because we have some fans that are regulars from Grand Falls and surrounding area.
Well, that's true, Jack, and every time Bishop Falls play, we have a lot of fans that come with the team, and they've been supporting the team now for a number of years. So 2 lucky fans, let's say, will win that trip, 2 hockey tickets to a St. John's Maple Leafs hockey game, Jack, and I can safely say I've only missed 2 games a year at Memorial Stadium, and the pro hockey is just fantastic. Now George Penny, stopped by Tony Kennedy, he's taken out of the play, and there's a shot by number 34, Jerry Penny. Now Penny taken out of the play by number 14, George Penny, and he's behind his own net. He's watched by number 44, Mike Bennett. Penny fires the puck to Leonard Ice, and Sugaroo has to make a save. Number 4, Paul Lingard, fires it out to Penny, and he's taken out of the play hard by George Penny. Number 19, Snow takes a shot, and a save by Roger Kennedy. Puck is shot back to center ice. Lingard fires it over the Badger blue line, where Mike Bennett intercepted the pass, and now Yumi Holland, a 2-man break. He's over the Bishop Falls blue line. There's a shot by Wayne Little, and Barry Sugaroo comes up big once again. Stretch Hayden loses the puck to Lingard. He shoots it down the ice. And Jack, Barry Sugaroo has been fantastic in the Bishop Falls net tonight.
He's the difference in this hockey game right now, Ted.
A 2-on-1 break, Yubi Hollett. I let the shot go, and Sugaroo came up big. Lingard fires a wide ring pass to 79, Craig Ellis, and it's offside.
Yes, Sugaroo certainly is the difference in this hockey game at the moment. He's been frustrating the Badger shooters all night. And that was certainly one big save off of Wayne Little.
Jack, with the Bishop Falls Express, it always seems like we have a Faulkner in the lineup. And tonight, Wayne is out. Gino's not playing, but we have number 12, Bill Faulkner. A name synonymous with hockey in Bishop Falls and, of course, right across Newfoundland. Pucks is behind the Bishop Falls net. Russ Kennedy taken out of the play. Now Robbie Penny fires it in front. There's Russ Kennedy with a shot, and he just grazed the goalpost. Howdy fight for possession, Russ Kennedy. And number 16 for Bishop Falls, Kenny Fowler, shoots it down the ice. Russ Kennedy grazing the goalpost on that shot. Now Keith Loader makes his way to center ice up to Russ Kennedy. He's stopped by number 79, Craig Ellis. And the puck is shot in the corner. Len Penny fires it off the boards. And we'll have an icing call, and we'll have a face-off right back here deep in the Bishop Falls zone to the left of Barry Sugaroo, Jack. And as we mentioned, Barry Sugaroo just coming up big tonight, and he's the big difference in this game right now.
Yes, and when he was beaten that time, he had his the goalpost was there to save him because Kennedy rattled out right off the outside of the goalpost. Beautiful setup in front.
And of course, just before that shot, Sugaroo comes up big against Yubi Hollett with a great glove save. And like we say, the big difference tonight, of course, is Sugaroo in the Bishop Falls net. There's Hollett with a shot. That's just one. And now here's a breakaway for Rob Fudge. Going down, there's a shot. And a big save by Roger Kennedy on Raj Fudge. Robbie Fudge went in all alone, and Kennedy, now Russ Kennedy comes back this end of the ice. Makes a nice move to get around some Bishop Falls players, keeps it in, and Greg Byrne. Stopped by Keith Loader. There's Loader, back to Hollett. Hollett fanned on the shot, now Loader back to Bobby Bolton. There's a shot, and another big save by Sugaroo. And Robbie Fudge shoots the puck down over center ice. Jack, this game's starting to come alive now on both ends by both the Bishop Falls Express and the Badger Bombers.
Big saves by Sugaroo. And Kennedy at the other end came up big on a breakaway.
Kennedy, Robbie Fudge, number six, who went in all alone. And Kennedy comes up with the big pad save. And then the rush comes right back in the Bishop Falls Express zone, and Sugaroo comes up big once again. It's 6:40 left in the second period. You're watching Hockey at its Best in the Central Newfoundland Beyond Hockey League. The Badger Bombers versus the Bishop Falls Express, and the Bishop Falls Express lead this game by a score of 3-1 with 6:40 left in the second period.
There's double penalties called that time. Ted Fowler has gone for Bishop's.
Right now, Badger is on the power play. Greg Byrne taken into the board by Wayne Little, number six. Stopped at his own blue line. Now Tony Kennedy fires it back to Greg Byrne. He's taken down the play by George Penny. There's a shot, he scores! Number eight, Greg Byrne. And the Bishop Falls Express go ahead by a score of 4-1.
Greg Byrne shot from the blue line. Kennedy again looked a bit weak on that one. Right along the ice all the way to his blocker side. The penalty was called against Badger to Harry Foley, so they were on a power play at the time.
Lynn Penny shoots the puck off the boards behind his own net to center ice. George Penny at the Bishop Falls blue line. Fires it off the board. Yubi Hollett out front. And Bobby Bunting, there's a shot. And Steve Burns. That was number 12, Wayne Sullivan, once again stopped by Barry Sugaroo.
Sugaroo continues to come up big. He is the big difference in this hockey game tonight.
5:51 left in the second period. Mike Bennett takes the face off against Yubi Hollett. Bennett wins the draw. Back to Dan Sullivan. Makes a nice move to get away from Hollett. And he's taken out of the play by number 18, Wayne Little. Now Mike Bennett, now we have some roughing to the side of the Bishop Falls net. Wayne Little and Dan Sullivan go heavily to the ice. And the play was blown down.
Penalty?
Yeah.
And penalties. We have penalties, Jack.
Yeah, penalties, I think, to both Badger and Bishop Falls. Wayne Little and Dan Sutherland are both going for holding, I think.
5:37 left in the second period. The Bishop Falls Express lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 4-1. Len Penny and Tony Kennedy back on the defense. We have Mike Bennett and number 34, Jerry Penny, and number 19, Greg Snow. Both teams playing five aside. Now Greg Snow stopped at the blue line, and Yubi Holland. And now Yubi Holland and Greg Snow. And we have a little 50 cup going on here, Jack, Greg Snow and Hubert Holland. And the official, they get in there fairly quick. Things are starting to get a little rough now, Jack, with the Bishop Falls Express leading the Bombers by a score of 4-1.
Yes, I think Snow took exception to the way that Hollett shot the puck across the ice for no reason. It wouldn't take much to start something here tonight, I don't think. Between those, they've been rivals for so long that it takes very little to start something. Bishop Falls has scored the only two goals of this period. They led 2-1 after one. And right now they have upped it to 4-1.
Now referee Burr Brown is going to have to get control of this hockey game, Jack, if he doesn't want anything to break out.
Yes, I think he's put Hollett in the penalty box, maybe for misconduct. I'm not sure of that yet.
Well, we'll get the official time off the penalties. 5:24 left in the second period, and you're watching Hockey at its Best on Channel 9 Central Cable Atlantic. It's the Badger Bombers versus the Bishop Falls Express, and the Bishop Falls Express lead this game over the Badger Bombers by a score of 4-1. They'll line up now for the face-off to the left of Roger Kennedy. All coincidental penalties, both teams play five aside. And the play is blown down at the Bishop Falls blue line. Four to one, to the Bishop Falls Express lead the Badger Bombers. 5:09 left in the second period. I think the fans were expecting a rough game here tonight, Jack. This is the last time that those two teams meet in the season. And the fans were expecting a rough game, but nothing big has developed, and that's good.
No, I think the fans are disappointed at tonight's game, and especially being down 4-1 at this juncture. And there seems to be something going on at the penalty box again. We're not sure what it is.
Well, this play was blowing down approximately about 5 minutes ago, and they're still arguing the call, and unless Blair Brown, the referee, takes control of this game, he'll just be skating back and forth across the ice all night talking to the coaches. He's got to go over there, Jack, lay the penalties down, and call back, come back, blow the whistle, and line up for the faceoff. I think Steve Croucher has been thrown out of the game.
This is what I find in the refereeing in the Central Biotic League, that it takes so long to call penalties instead of just going over and giving out the penalties and then coming back, roll the whistle, get the play on the go. And the fans are the same. They have the same thing in the stands here. They say, look, why don't you do that? We're over there freezing to death. And it takes so long to call penalties.
Well, Lester Sparks, now the general manager of the Badger Bombers team, is heading down towards the bench, and it looks like Steve Croucher has been kicked out of the game for arguing too strenuously against referee Blair Brown. Now we're back to action. Greg Byrne up to Mike Bennett, to Rob Fodges at center ice over the Badger blue line, stopped by Perry Paul. And Rob Fodge again with possession of the puck. It's between his skates, he couldn't find it. And now the puck. Mike Bennett fires it up the center ice to Darren Drover. He loses it to Robbie Penny, who couldn't get it out over his own blue line. And Mike Bennett intercepts the pass, fires it right back in. Now Robbie Penny fires it up to his own blue line. There's number 8, Greg Byrne. Here's Byrne winding up for the shot. Over to Tony Kennedy, there's a shot. And a save by Roger Kennedy. Now Russ Kennedy off the center ice, a speedster, gets around Fowler, there's a shot to decide the net. And Keith Loader takes out of the play by Len Penny. They'll fight for possession in the puck and Penny freezes it. And another faceoff with 3:20 left in the second period.
Score still remains 4-1 for Bishop Falls with 3:20 left in this period. They've added two goals to the 2-1 lead that they had at the end of the first period. And thanks to Barry Sugaroo that they lead 4-1 at this point.
Face off just inside the Bishop Falls blue line. Jerry Power will take the face off. And Mike Bennett lines up for the face-off for the Bishop Falls Express. While the referee skates to the penalty box again. Badger Bombers should be still shorthanded, but they have 5 players on the ice. And now number 3, Steve Burns, leaves the ice. And the Bishop Falls Express on the power play. Linger over to Sutherland. Sutherland stopped there by Steve Burns. And now Linger leaves it at center ice for Bobby Bogdan. Fires it in the corner behind the Bishop Falls net. Dan Sutherland out to his own blue line, up to Mike Bennett. He's at the Badger blue line over to Greg Snow. Snow's pass stopped, intercepted in the corner there, and they'll freeze it against the board for another face-off with 2:45 left in the second period.
Play very scrambly now at this point of the game.
Well, the play had picked up, Jack, early in the second period with a lot of end-to-end rushes. Both goaltenders, Roger Kennedy and Barry Sugaroo, coming up with some fantastic saves, but now seem to have slowed down again, and we're seeing some more sloppy play. And at 2:45 left in the period, the Express lead the Bombers by a score of 4-1. There's a shot and a save by Kennedy. Another shot, and that's why. Greg Byrne. Watch there by Wayne Little is out in front. And Bobby Bogdan. Up the center ice to Wayne Little. And he's stopped there by Paul Lindgren. Fires it back to center ice and picked up by Greg Snow. Ruby Holland. At center ice, stopped by Sutherland, and here's Bobby Bogdan. Fires it over the top of the net, and Wayne Little can't keep the puck in. Shot up to Greg Byrne, and it's offside.
Two-line offside, just barely over the red line from inside the blue line. A 2:07 remaining in the second period. The score is 4-1 for Bishop Falls. Sugaroo continues to keep that score down.
It's out just beside the Bishop Falls blue line. Ruby Holland picks it up. And that was a delayed offside. The puck had gone out and Penny had come in over the blue line. And it's whistled down and we'll have another face-off. Just outside the Bishop Falls blue line.
Badgers still playing shorthanded.
Jack, it's not really a big crowd as compared to last year when we televised a game for Central Cable. And I'd say we have about, 200 fans here tonight?
About 200 fans down around the boards and quite a few down around the boards that don't go to the stands.
Out is Greg Byrne, works his way over blue line to Darren Drover, and Ralph Fudge fails to pick up the pass inside the net. Wayne Little fires it behind the net to George Penny. He's up the center ice to Jerry Power. He loses the puck there, taken out of the play by Sutherland. Greg Byrne, watched by Stretch Hayden, who fires it in behind the Badger net, number six. Jerry Power over to UV Holland. Up to Wayne Little, he's stopped there by Sutherland. Greg Hayden. There goes number two, Sutherland. And he fakes a shot. Dipsy Doodles in the corner, watched by George Penny. And UV Holland leads it off to Greg Byrne. There's a shot, deflected off George Penny. Bill Faulkner fires it out front. And now Keith Loader. Up the center ice, up to UV Holland, he stopped there. And the play is blown down, Jack, and another face-off with 42 seconds left in the second period.
I think the referee is calling another penalty. This time to Bishop Falls. It looks like it's Bill Faulkner, number 12, I believe, is the guilty party.
Forty-two seconds left in the second period. The Express lead this one by a score of 4-1 as they line up for the face-off just outside the Bishop Falls blue line. Mike Benner loses the draw to Russ Kennedy. Terry Paul up the center ice. Kennedy failed to pick up the pass, and then Penny fires it off the boards. Now Terry Paul at center ice, taken out of the play by Jerry Golding. And he fires it back over the Badger blue line. Bobby Penny, 20 seconds left in the period. Keith Loader over to Junior Butt. Taken out of the play by Golding. Back to Terry Paul in the Russ Kennedy. He loses the puck and we got a tripping penalty coming up to the Bishop Falls Express with 7 seconds left. Kennedy was in front of the Bishop Falls net and he was hauled down from behind.
Yes, we had offsetting penalties on the last penalty call. It was Faulkner and Penny both going off.
Craig Penny will, Len Penny will take the penalty for hauling down Russ Kennedy. 7 seconds left in the period.
Tony Kennedy is arguing about that penalty with the referee Brown.
Face off to the right of Barry Sugaroo. And the buzzer is gone, but there's 7 seconds left in the period as referee Blair Brown skates over to the timekeeper's box. The face-off never took place with 7 seconds left, but the buzzer went. So they'll do it all over again. Russ Kennedy will take the face-off along with Keith Loader, Perry Paul, Robbie Penny, and Junior Butt. On the face-off, there's Penny a shot. And that's high over the top of the net. 1 second left, there's the buzzer. And the second period is over. And the Bishop Falls Express lead the Badger Bombers by a score of 4-1, Jack, and a rundown now of the scoring in the second period.
Yes, Ted, at the end of the second period, it was already at 2-1 when Sutherland scored from Ellis, and then Greg Byrne scored from Drover and Kennedy to make the score 4-1 after two periods of play.
And we'll be right back after this important message with the third period of play between the Badger Bombers and the Bishop Falls Express.
Hi, I'm Susan Bonnell, host of Cable 9's quiz program Trivia Plus. This year, the show is bigger and better than ever, with 24 high schools competing province-wide and over $5,000 in scholarships and prizes on the line. So tune in to Cable 9 starting January 29th at 8 p.m. for Trivia Plus.
Bishop Falls are 2 men short by the look of what's on the ice right now, and I think this is what concerned the referee.
The Badger Bombers will be on the power play, and the puck is dropped, and Tony Kennedy shoots it right back in the Badger end with number 5, Peary Paul, circles around his own net, makes a nice play out to Wayne Little at the Bishop Falls blue line over to Ross Kennedy. Kennedy leads it for Robbie Penny. And there's a shot by Russ Kennedy, and he didn't miss by very much on that one. Number 18, Wayne Little, fights for possession of the puck with Dan Sutherland. Or it's number 16, Kenny Fowler, and we'll have a face-off to the left of Barry Sugaroo.
Bishop Falls are 2 men short, so Badger need to score early here to get back in this hockey game.
From the face-off, Kennedy wins the draw over to Peary Paul. Bishop Falls has the box set up, and Greg Byrne intercepts that pass before it's beaten to the Badger end. Robbie Penny, number 66, up to center ice to Peary Paul, over to Russ Kennedy. He moves in on Sugaroo, and it's a shot. And he missed the net again. Paul in the Keith Loader. Loader fires it out in front. That's intercepted again by Greg Byrne. He shoots it deep in the Badger end. Roger Kennedy up to his own blue line, leads it for Peary Paul. He's watched there by Greg Byrne. Bobby Penny will try it. At the Bishop Falls blue line, leads it for Keith Loader. Ring wide pass to Russ Kennedy. Kennedy watched by Greg Byrne. Kennedy dipsy dooling. Leads it for Robbie Penny over to Peary Paul. Now Robbie Penny right in front. And a nice save by Sugaroo. Greg Byrne bars it up the ice. And Robbie Penny bars it up to Wayne Little. He's over to Bishop Falls blue line. Circles behind the Bishop Falls net. Comes out in front to Peary Paul. Peary Paul over to number 4. Howell lets a shot go. He scores! Rodney Howell on a hard slap shot, Jack, from the blue line. I don't know if Sugaroo was screened or if the puck was deflected in.
I think he didn't. He misjudged that puck, did, by the way he looked after it went in. It seemed to go right between his legs from Rodney Howell at the point.
Well, like you just mentioned, Jack, the Bombers need a goal early in this third period to get back into the game, and this could be the goal that turns it around.
You still have one man advantage, did, from now.
And the Bombers still on the power play. Howell over to Bobby Bogdan, up the center ice. That's intercepted by Bishop Falls Express, and Bobby Bogdan takes it behind his own net. Up to Peter Evans, number 7, bars it off the center ice over to Bishop Falls blue line. And Sutherland bars it right back to center ice. 4:45, the time of the goal. There's a shot by Howell. And that's blocking another shot. That's a weak one. And it's behind the net. Now Sutherland fires a shot. And that's blocked by Sugaroo. Aaron Jolber bars it behind his own net off the boards. Up to the Badger end, and Roger Kennedy shoots it out to the blue line. To Sullivan. Pass up to Yubi Holland. He fails to pick it up. And number 4, Howell. Rodney Howell fights for possession of the puck along with Darren Drover. And now Lingard. Up the center ice to Greg Byrne. Drover. Back to Sutherland. Over the blue line. There's a shot to Greg Byrne, and a pad save by Roger Kennedy. Steve Burns and Greg Byrne fight for possession of the puck, and they'll blow it down, and we'll have a face-off with 16:47 left in the third period. But the Bishop Falls Express leading the Badger Bombers by a score of 4-2. And you're watching Hockey at its Best on Channel 9, Central Cable Atlantic. Steve Burns lines up for the face-off against Mike Bennett, number 9, Junior Bunch. Shoots it out to center ice for Len Penny. Races for the puck and shoots it right back, and is picked up by George Penny at his own blue line. He's up to center ice. That's a shot goal. That's wide. And number 34, Jerry Penny, shoots it back in where Hayden, behind his own blue line, watched by Mike Bennett. Can't get it out, fired right back in where George Penny, watched by Mike Bennett. And that pass to the blue line, stopped by Greg Snow. And Penny will try it again. Another pass picked up by number 6, Jerry Power, up to Junior Butt. It's in the corner. Shot off the boards. And it's picked up. Fired up to Jerry Penny. He's over to Badger blue line. Cuts in front. And a weak shot. And Roger Kennedy will make the save on Jerry Penny.
Jerry Paul got caught that time, Ted, on the other end, and created the 2-on-1. It was a very weak shot that Kennedy stopped.
Craig Loader got thrown out of this game early in the first period. And then coach Steve Croucher gets thrown out the latter part of the second period. Lester Sparks now behind the bench coaching the Badger Bombers from the faceoff. Harry Paul takes the puck behind his own net. Taken into the boards by Craig Ellis. Puck is shot off the center ice for Dan Sullivan. Over to Ellis. Fires it in over the Badger blue line and stop. Now Ellis will try it again. And Robbie Penny picks up the puck, fires it over to Perry Paul. Out to center ice. And now Golding leaves it, and Paul picks it up. Fires it in to the express end. And it comes up to number 12, Bill Faulkner. Faulkner, a nice pass over to Craig Ellis, and he failed to pick it up. Harry Paul now circling in his own zone. Fires it up to Ross Kennedy. He's watched there by Ellis. Robbie Penny over to Perry Paul off the board to Keith Loader. Circles at his own blue line at center ice. A delayed penalty on the play to the Bishop Falls Express. And Keith Loader taken in on the board by number 16, Kenny Fowler, and Jack. A delayed penalty on the play to the Bishop Falls Express.
This is another penalty being called, and that was another power play for the Bombers, and they're down by 2 goals with 14:27 left in the third period, and Bill Faulkner has been called for the penalty.
And the Badger Bombers will go on the power play once again, and still 14 and a half minutes left in this third period, and a great opportunity for the Bombers to come within 1 goal. Hollett will face off against Greg Byrne. Hollett wins the draw. Puck is shot in the corner where Byrne picks it up, fires it off the boards and out to center ice. Bobby Bugger. Two minutes for high sticking to Bill Faulkner at 5:33. Out of puck is in the Russ Kennedy. At the Hollett, back to Russ Kennedy, shot across in front, and Hollett failed to put it in. Bobby Bugden lets a shot go, and that's deflected just to the side of the net. Tony Kennedy picks the puck, shoots it in the Badger end with Roger Kennedy. He's been watched by Greg Byrne, fires it off to Hollett. Hollett at his own blue line, up to Wayne Little, he's over to Bishop Falls Express blue line, leaves it for Hollett. Hollett in the corner, watched by Paul Lindgaard, who takes the puck from Hollett and fires it up the center ice to Greg Byrne. Byrne Still with the puck, Dipsy Doolin in his own end, killing off precious penalty time. Where Russ Kennedy makes a nice move to get around Kennedy off the Bishop Falls Express. Number four, Holland. Howell. Back to Rodney Howell. In the corners out in front to Russ Kennedy, and there's a weak shot. And that shot out to the Badger blue line. Now a breakaway from the Bishop Falls Express, a shot. And Rob Fudge missed the net by about 2 feet, and now he scores! Number eight, Craig Byrne picked up the loose puck behind the net after Rob Fudge had gone in all alone and just come out to the side of the net, Jack, and just fired it between the legs of Roger Kennedy.
Yes, Ted, that was a Bugden fell at the blue line that created the breakaway for Fudge. Fudge came in and missed the net, but Greg Byrne followed up and just picked the puck up behind the net, skated out in front, and Kennedy didn't know where the puck was, really.
And, Jack, that was a shorthanded goal by the Bishop Falls Express as they now go ahead again, once again by 3 goals, by a score of 5-2. Badger Bombers still on the power play from the faceoff. Pete Evans at center ice, taken out of the play by Mike Bennett. And Fowler sends it up to the Badger blue line. George Penny works his way back into the Bishop Falls zone. Gets around Mike Bennett in the corner. There's a shot by Pete Evans. And it's off the boards and fired back in the Badger end. Roger Kennedy leaves it behind his own net for number 12, Wayne Sullivan. Makes his way to the blue line, up to Pete Evans at center ice. There's a shot, wide. Hangs up on the side of the net, and we'll have another face-off. 12-10 left the third period, and now it's on 50 cups in front of the ball bit, Jack.
Yes, this is to be expected, Ted. They're down by 3 goals now, and I think frustration is starting to set in. As Bishop Falls has certainly played
this
hockey game tonight.
Harry Foley in the thick of things out there, number 16. Just seen limited action tonight, and I think that's his second or third shift, and that's who's in the pileup right now to the right of Barry Sugaroo.
Yes, I think he was sent out there, Ted, to stir up things and maybe wake up the Bombers, because they certainly haven't played their game tonight.
They certainly haven't, Jack, and while the officials now will try to break this one up, I'm sure the boys will just go off for roughing minors. And now number 16 for Bishop Falls trying to get back at Foley. And of course number 16, Kenny Fowler, who's played a solid game on defense tonight for the Express. And he'll go to the penalty box and he'll be followed by Foley, number 16. Now Foley stops in front of the Bishop Falls Express in front of their bench, and he says some words to the players.
Both players are being given 5 minutes on a game. I think they're both being true out of this game.
And Jack, I think that's a good move by the officials right now with 12 minutes left in the game. And the instigators now of those fights, a good move by the officials to eject those players right from the game before things get out of hand.
Local by Harry Foley is a big fan favorite here in town.
Foley's gone for the game, as well as number 16, one of the defensemen from the Bishop Falls Express, and this all takes place with 12:01 left in the third period. And the Express leading the Bombers by a score of 5-2. And both players ejected
Badger
from the game.
Number 16, Foley. Bishop Falls number 16, Foley. 5 minutes each for fighting, the game is counted. Tom Foley,
7:59, the time of the penalties, Jack. 5 minute fighting majors and game misconducts. Now the officials will fix the net behind Barry Sugaroo as the team lines up for the faceoff just inside the Bishop Falls Express blue line. From the draw, puck is shot to center ice. Perry Hall fires the puck high over the glass in the Bishop Falls end, and the faceoff will be brought right back into the Badger end.
He called for icing, and Perry Hall shot that puck this side of his own red line.
They'll line up for the faceoff. to the left of Roger Kennedy. He'll be Hollett. Faces off against Mike Bennett. Hollett wins the draw. Fury Paul right in front of Roger Kennedy. Out to his own blue line. Intercepted by Mike Bennett and shot right back in. Bobby Penny, 66. Up to Fury Paul. No acing on the call. Number two, Sullivan. Shoots it around the boards. And now Yubi Hollett. And I think Sugaroo have a few words.
Yeah, penalty's being called again by referee Brown. He's going to keep this one under control with 11:31 left, and Mitchell Falls leading 5-2.
.11:31 left in the third period. The Bishop Falls Express lead in this game by a 5-2 score over the Badger Bombers as they line up for the faceoff to the right of Barry Sugaroo. Teams will play five aside, Jack, with 11:31 left. Coincidental penalties. The team will play five aside. Puck is back at center ice. Harry Paul shoots it right back in. And Len Penny. Over to Kennedy. And we'll have an icing on the play. And the faceoff right back deep in the Bishop Falls end.
Play again a little sloppy at this stage of the game with 11:11 left in the third period.
Steve Burns takes the face off for the Bombers against Bill Faulkner. Over to Robbie Penny. There's a shot. He scores! A low, hard snapshot from just inside the blue line. Let go by Robbie Penny. Down the target to the stick side of goaltender Barry Sugaroo, Jack, and the Bombers are right back in this game once again.
Yes, Sugaroo had no chance on that one. You could hear it hit the post from down here. It hit the side of the post and went in. And was set up by Perry Paul. He played a very strong game for Badger Tech.
.8:55 the time of the goal. And a scramble in the front of the net. And Roger Kennedy covers up with 10:52 left. And the Express lead this one by a score of 5-3. And they'll line up for the faceoff to the right of Roger Kennedy. From the draw, puck shot behind the net around the board, tipped in by Sullivan, who takes on the play by Steve Burns. To number 15, Brogdon, and Darren Jolbert fight for possession, and Russ Kennedy comes up the puck, he loses it again, and there's a shot by Greg Byrne, and that was stopped by Rodney Howell. Greg Byrne at center ice, there's a shot by Rob Fridge, and that was wide. Brogdon fires it up to center right, Pete Loader. And we have an offside, 10:15 left in the game. 5-3, the Bishop Falls Express lead the Bombers. And we'll have a face-off just outside the Bishop Falls blue line.
It was a good chance there created by Pete Loader that time, but Russ Kennedy went offside.
From the face-off, Bobby Brogdon at his own blue line. Rink-wide pass to Rodney Howell, back to Brogdon. Fires it up to center ice to Keith Loader. Loader fires it deep and the Bishop falls in. Darren Drover taken out of the play by Wayne Sullivan and Greg Byrne. At center ice, there's Bishop Falls right in front of the net. Round five, just another shot by Len Penny high over the top of the net. Robbie Fudge playing a solid game tonight for the Bishop Falls Express. Howell up the loader. He stopped at his own blue line. And we have an offside with 9:25 left in the game. And the Express lead this one by a score of 5-3. Kennedy having trouble getting the puck out of his big catching glove there for the official as he takes it back outside the Badger blue line where Mike Bennett will take the faceoff against Yubi Holler. From the draw, Bennett wins the faceoff to Kennedy. Bars it in. Roger Kennedy gloves that one and leaves it for George Penny. Penny over to Sullivan. Back to Penny at his own blue line. Up to center ice. Bars it in the corner for Tony Kennedy. Shoots it around his own net. And Sullivan fights for possession of the puck with Mike Bennett. Bennett loses the puck to Wayne Little, and now we have George Penny and Paul Lingard have words in front of the Bishop Falls net. Now Penny wanting to get at Lingard once again. Two big boys, Jack, and while Lingard doesn't want any part of it. And rightly so, 8:57 left the game, leading by two goals. Mike Bennett, number 44, brings it up to center ice. He's stopped there by Wayne Little. Still has possession of the puck, shoots it over to Darren Drover. Drover over to Greg Byrne, and Rob Fudge failed to pick up the pass. Byrne. Great wide pass to Tony Kennedy up to Darren Drover. That's intercepted by Terry Paul. And he's over to Bishop Falls blue line and stopped by Greg Byrne. Penny up to Yubi Holler. Again stopped by Tony Kennedy. And the Badger Bombers are killing off this penalty very well. Now they're over the Badger blue line. Shot in front, there's a shot by Greg Byrne, and that's why Sutherland. Oh! Sutherland was hit hard by Robbie Penny, and now Darren Drover, we don't know who the Bomber player is on the bottom of the pile, but Darren Drover and Perry Paul. Drover and Paul.
That was a great check delivered by Robbie Penny.
And they'll both go to the penalty box. But Jack Dan Sutherland took a crushing body check from Robbie Penny just to the left of Roger Kennedy. But Sutherland just smiles at Penny and skates into the play.
I'm sure he felt that, Ted. You could hear it way up here. It was one of the best checks I've seen thrown all year in this league.
It was a beautiful body check, but Sutherland took it all in stride. And now we have penalties once again, and the referee will sort them out at center ice just in front of the penalty box. 7:25 left in the game, and the Bishop Falls Express lead this game over the Badger Bombers by a score of 5-3. And it looks like right now, the teams will play four sides.
2 minutes from fourth place. Bishop Falls number 15, Drover. 2 minutes for Rumpage, and
2 minutes for the eighth. Time of penalty, 12:35.
12:35, the time of the penalties. Right back in action, Bobby Bogdan takes the puck at his own blue line. Up to Keith Loader, fires it deep in the Bishop Falls end. Russ Kennedy fires it out in front. There's Bogdan, and he fanned on the shot. And Keith Loader grabs possession of the puck, loses it to Tony Kennedy, picks it up again, fires it out in front. There's a shot, and a skate saved by Barry Sugaroo out Rodney Howell. Now rink-wide pass to number six, Rob Fudge, who failed to pick it up, and Rodney Howell. Back to Russ Kennedy, and he tries to go around Tony Kennedy, but couldn't. Now George Penny picks up the puck, and that's fired out to center ice. Bogdan for the Bombers behind his own net, watched by Greg Byrne. And he leads it for Russ Kennedy, the little speedster. He's up to center ice, and of course he's stopped there by Bennett. Now here's Dan Sutherland in all of all being taken down. There's no penalty on the play, but he was taken down from behind by Keith Loader. Now Robbie Penny fires it over the boards, and we have a face-off just inside the blue line, Jack, and Bishop Falls Express, Dan Sullivan, had a great opportunity that time. It was hauled down from behind by Keith Loader. There was no penalty on the play.
No, I was watching the referee, and he waved it off. But getting back to that penalty on Perry Paul, it was called. Extra 2 minutes for
unsportsmanlike conduct.
But Bishop Falls got a double minor at the same time.
Coincidental penalties, the teams will play five aside. Holler. Goalie moves out of the face-off circle. And Greg Snow moves in now. Ben Penny fires it back to center ice for Stretch Hayden. Fires it off to Ellis, intercept, and oh! Ellis was knocked flat by number 14, George Penny. The referee blows the play down here.
He's going to get a charging penalty, I think.
A charging penalty to George Penny. George Penny goes to the penalty box. George Penny for charging. And Jack, he took number 79, Craig Ellis, heavy. Just outside the blue line.
It's lucky that Ellis seen him in time because he escaped most of the check.
A hard check by George Penny, and the referee gives him a 2 minute penalty for charging.
He took about five strides before he got to Ellis.
Well, certainly was charging, Jack. As you mentioned, Penny took about five strides before he hit Ellis. 2 minutes for charging. 5:44 left the game.
This puts stress on the Bombers now, being two goals down with 5:44 left.
Al Linger lets a shot go wide of the net. And a hold up on the side of the mesh. And we'll have another face-off. Time running out, Jack. 5:39 left in the game. The Bombers down by two in their home stadium as the Bishop Falls Express come in here tonight in the Badger Stadium and probably going home with 2 points.
Looks like they're going to steal 2 points tonight. I don't think the Bombers were quite ready for this game tonight.
They certainly were, Jack. They were, it looked like from all sorts of talk around the town, they were up for the game, but they certainly didn't come out that way. They came out a bit flat in the first period. They played good in the second, and now they're playing flat again in the third. Mike Bennett shoots it up the center ice, intercepted by Yubi Hollett over to Robbie Penny. Wayne Little stopped by Tony Kennedy, and now Hollett circles back his own end. Off to Robbie Penny, a rink-wide pass, a high pass which Wayne Little certainly couldn't pick up, and a shot off the board to Mike Bennett. And number 11, Tony Kennedy. Up to center ice, now there's Greg Byrne in all alone, and a pass saved by Roger Kennedy. A beautiful save off the stick of Greg Byrne. Tony Kennedy taken heavily into the boards by Greg Hayden, number two of the Bombers. Lindgren fires it up the center ice to Mike Bennett. Bennett watched by Hayden. Bennett comes up with the puck again. That's a shot goal. It's off the corner boards. And Penny fires it all the way down the ice. No icing call. Bobby Bugden takes a shot from center ice. That's stopped by Sugaroo. Puck back to Badger end. Had to kill off this penalty with the Express on the power play. Bobby Bugden back to Rodney Howell. Been watched here by Greg Snow. Howell's at center ice over the blue line. Gets around one defenseman, taken out of the play by Len Penny. Sutherland fights for possession with Russ Kennedy along the end boards. And Sutherland comes up to the puck, fires it off to center ice. Roger Kennedy fires it behind his own net. And Greg Byrne fails to pick it up. Now there's a weak shot. And Kennedy down on both knees will cover up. And we'll have another face-off with 3:19 left in the game.
The Bombers killed off that penalty to George Penny, and now they have 3 minutes and 19 seconds to try to get the 2 goals to tie this game. And I think that they've taken a timeout.
Loader, Russ Kennedy, and Wayne Little will form the line up front for the Bombers. While Greg Snow, Darren Drover, will line up for Bishop Falls with Tony Kennedy and Len Penny on defense. From the faceoff, Robbie Fudge loses the draw. It's in the stretch, Hayden. He's up the center ice to Wayne Little, fires it over to Bishop Falls blue line, and the puck is fired right back in the Badger end. Kennedy lays it for Holler. A rink wide pass to George Penny. That's center ice. Back to Holland. Holland makes a nice move. There's a shot. And another shot. And another big pad saved by Barry Sugaroo. Out of puck is intercepted by Greg Byrne. And it's picked off by Wayne Little. He's over the Bishop Falls blue line. That's a weak shot goal. Sugaroo go down to cover up with 2:39 left in the game.
Hubert Holler certainly had a great chance that time, but Sugaroo came up big again. As he's been coming up all night, he's the difference to this hockey game.
All I can say, 2:39 left in the game, and Barry Sugaroo has been the difference in this one as he makes save after save after save. The Express lead by two. Now there's a shot by Wayne Little to Paul Lindgard. And I think Wayne Little will take a penalty, and once again, Paul Lindgren want to know part of the act, and the Badger Bombers end up in the sin bin.
I think that's the straw did right there with Little taking a foolish penalty down the Bishop Falls end. It's not going to do his team any good this night.
Well, 2:39 left in the game to line up for the faceoff to the right of Barry Sugaroo.
Both teams are changing. The referee is letting them go on. And now Bishop Falls have taken a 30-second timeout.
Well, another 30-second timeout. I'd like to say, Jack, this time by the Bishop Falls Express, they lead by two as they regroup in front of their coach, Wayne Faulkner. 17:21, the time of the penalty. As the Bishop Falls Express once again go on the power play. And the Badger Bombers will have to kill off the last 2 minutes of this game with 39 seconds left to play after the penalty is over. Jack, once again, we mentioned Ron Haley, the recreation director from Bishop Falls, and of course, former provincial referee, no stranger to sports fans right across the province, Donnie Walsh, a great guy to know. And you had to know Donnie to, you have a lot of fun with him, Jack. And Donnie was gracious enough to leave two tickets to be put up for a draw for a game to the St. John's Maple Leafs at Memorial Stadium in St. John's. From the faceoff, Paul at the center ice lets a weak shot go. Sugaroo steers that through behind the net where Keith Faller takes Greg Byrne out of the play. Goes right back in after the puck, and number 10, Russ Kennedy, makes a nice move to get around. There's a shot in front of the net, and Sugaroo, Jack, comes up big once again.
Sugaroo, as we've been saying all night, I say he's the first star of this hockey game. He's come up big all night. Every time that they get a chance in close, he's been there.
All the Badger Bombers are killing off this penalty, and it seems like they're on the power play.
They had a great chance to crawl within, to get to within one goal on that opportunity.
Brown blows the whistle for the faceoff. There goes a water bottle on the ice from the Badger Bomber bench.
Now the fans are getting into the act now, throwing things on the ice.
Now the penalty call is made. Brown should blow his whistle. Call for the face-off. There's no need of explaining anything else. The stick was illegal. The penalty is called. Let's go on with the game.
Well, this is what we've had to put up with in this league. The officiating is not what it should be. And it happens all the time. You're sitting in the stands, and a game that should be over at 9:30 runs into 10:30.
While they line up for the face-off, just outside the Bishop Falls blue line, Russ Kennedy will come and take the face-off. And Badger will play two men short. Tony Kennedy. Rink wide pass to Lingard. Robbie Penny stopped there by Darren Drover. Puck comes in behind the net. Robbie Budd shoots it out front. And Russ Kennedy fires it off the center right. This is shot by Lingard. Stopped by Roger Kennedy as Robbie Penny fires it out over his own blue line. Bishop Falls now regroup. But Greg Byrne takes the puck behind his own net on the pass from Tony Kennedy as they set up the play. Now Kennedy over to Paul Lingard up the center ice. But Darren Drover missed the pass. And Roger Kennedy fires it right out over the blue line. And we have an offside, Jack, with 1:29 left in the game.
Well, Bishop Falls come in here tonight, and they're going to take home 2 points. They stole them from the Bombers. They played this game to their game plan to perfection.
From the faceoff, Kennedy wins the draw. Back to George Penny. Circles around behind his own blue line. Watched by Darren Drover. Penny behind his own net, gets away from Drover over his own blue line up the center ice. And he's stopped there by number 4, Paul Lingard. Now Penny and Lingard having words, a delayed penalty. Sugaroo goes to the bench for the extra man. And now Penny goes after Lingard once again. And now Robbie Penny and Greg Byrne having words. George Penny and Lingard. And now Robbie Penny.
This game is over now, Ted. They should look forward. They got to play last night tomorrow. And if those players get fighting penalties now, they're gone for tomorrow's game. So they should think about that, too.
That's right. 1:03 left in the game. It's sad now if anything really big breaks out.
Well, it's not going to help the hockey club.
I think we should have some security down there now. Let's hope we get some security down there right away now, as things are happening in the Bishop Falls bench. I don't know who's into it right now, Jack. I think one of the coaches or the trainer at the Bishop Falls Express down there, and somebody's trying to get at him. I don't know where our security is at, but I think they should get down there fairly quick.
Joe Peckford is in the middle of things there, and I see one security coming around the other end down there. And Greg Byrne and Roger Kennedy are now talking together, and that could result into something.
And now Roger Kennedy throws off the mask. He wants to get at Greg Byrne.
Greg Byrne will have no part of this, I can tell you that right now, Ted.
Ted, let's get back to the start of this. The officials should have had Robbie Penny off the ice through the gate by now. He's still on the ice, and if this thing gets ugly, now Robbie is trying, or Roger Kennedy is still trying to get at Greg Byrne. Greg Byrne doesn't want no part of this. Kennedy challenging Greg Byrne from center ice.
Well, Donnie Walsh just came in here, Donnie, as a former senior referee, Donnie. This thing could get bad. Just tell us what the referees and the officials should be doing right now so this doesn't get out of hand.
Well, Ted, at this stage of the game right now, I really don't think there's much that they can do. You know, other than just try to keep the two teams apart, because at this moment, I think that the first guy that, or somebody that throws a punch, this place is that they're going to be able to preserve the firecracker. It's going to set the whole place afire. I mean, as far as I can see right at this moment, they're standing around talking. Not much that the linesman or the referee can do other than just try to keep the peace. But I think if somebody throws a punch, up she goes.
Okay, Donnie, after the initial flare-up, should the officials have gotten the two players involved off the ice through the gate right away, but they are still on the ice?
Absolutely. As soon as possible, because what that leaves, the longer they stay on the ice, then what happens is you've got other people, like you see out there now, one, there's actually, there's the first three or four people that left the bench, even though there's no actual fight on the ice, should be assessed penalties for leaving the bench during an altercation on the ice. And now you got both teams out on the ice, and now you got a real serious problem. What do you say? You know, I really don't, I mean, to me, in my opinion, I mean, and I guess everybody has their own opinion, but I honestly don't believe that there was reason to call that game. I honestly don't believe. I mean, he had it under control. All he had to do was give his penalties, get the game going. There was only whatever, what was left, a minute and so, I can't remember how many minutes, probably a minute and a half, but there was no reason to call the game. He could have got the game going, it was over, it was done, there was nothing volatile on the ice, there was no big brawl. So, to me, I'm just standing here and I don't know what to say to you. I don't know why you called the game.
They're waiting for the Badger Bombers to leave the ice before the Bishop Falls Express, and I think that's good too. It's a good move on referee.
It's a wise move on his part, yes.